हाँ, और in act 2 scene 2 we talked about the scene was about Trinculo, Caliban and Stephen, right? And then Caliban was made to drink, was given wine by Stefano, and he started considering him to be some divine creature, and he wanted to serve him, right? He said that I'll be your slave, I'll kiss your foot, and I will be your slave forever, right? You be the master, and you become the owner of this island. And then he decides to do away with his service to Prospero, right? He wants to free himself from Prospero. So now, this act 3 scene 1 takes place in front of Prospero's cell, before Prospero's cell. And who all are present? Ferdinand is present. You remember what happened to Ferdinand? Ferdinand was asked to pile up the logs, right? He was given some tedious task which was not suitable for him by Prospero. And why did Prospero do this? Because he wanted to test his love for Miranda. You remember? Prospero said that the things which are achieved easily, the prize which is won easily loses its value. This is what he said. Because Ferdinand and Miranda, they fell in love at first sight. Miranda was also taking Ferdinand's side, was also pleading to Prospero for Ferdinand that please don't be so harsh to him, right? Don't give him such tedious work to do, right? Please don't keep him in prison. So these were the things which were being said by Miranda. Prospero even tried to lure her by saying that he is not the most handsome person. There are more handsome men than Ferdinand. And if you will see those more handsome men, what will happen? Then he will seem to you like whom? Like Caliban. In front of those more handsome men, Ferdinand will be Caliban. You are finding him handsome because till now you have not seen anyone. You have only seen Caliban, right? Who is a very ugly creature. So in front of Caliban, he is very handsome. But if you will see some more handsome men, then this Ferdinand will seem to be no better than Caliban. So I hope you remember. So these were the things which were told by Prospero. And then Prospero is very happy with how Ariel has done his job and made Ferdinand and Miranda fall in love with each other. So he says he decides to make this whole thing of falling in love and getting involved with each other more difficult. Why? So that is why he creates problems for Ferdinand. See, if a person's love is not sincere, then he will give up after some time, right? He will surrender. Are why to make a hell of my life for this? I'll find someone better. Right? So there is no need to kill yourself. So that is why. Because he believes, Prospero believes that the things which are achieved after facing a lot of difficulty, after facing problems, they are more valued. So he wanted Ferdinand to prove his love for Miranda. So that is why he makes him undergo these difficulties. So Ferdinand is there working in front. The scene opens with Ferdinand and he is there working in front of Prospero's cell, fetching the logs and piling them. So he's carrying the logs and he is very happy about it. Why is he happy about it? He's happy to have found Miranda, right? And that Miranda is unmarried, because you remember he asked. So, and that they have fallen in love with each other. So he's very happy about his love, right? So now, see, this scene is important because it will talk about Ferdinand and Miranda, their interaction. And you will come to know how pure and innocent their love is. And see, the love story of Ferdinand and Miranda is important because it will lead to atonement and reconciliation of this all this enmity which is taking place between the two parties, that is King Alonso and Tony on one side and Prospero, right? Their love will sort out the differences and resolve the issue. So the love of Ferdinand and Miranda is important. There is a question on atonement and reconciliation, right? How the things will be reconciled because of their love, and the compensation of the injuries and the hurt which was inflicted and the pain which was inflicted upon Prospero, that will be resolved because of their love, because of the love of Ferdinand and Miranda. So their love story plays a very important role which cannot be ignored. So all the hostilities, all the betrayals and all these enmity, they will be sorted out because of this love. So, and one more thing happens, that Prospero is in a position to control everyone. Everyone is in Prospero's control. He seems to control every creature, which is being talked about in this act. Everyone is acting according to the way Prospero wanted, right? So they are being controlled. Their mind is being controlled by Prospero. Nobody is actually acting in his or her own way. They are acting according to the will of Prospero. So this is another important point of this scene. Act 3, scene 1. So enter Ferdinand bearing law. So he is, Ferdinand enters and he is carrying a law. There are some sports. Some sports are painful and their labor delight in themselves. So he says that there are some tasks, there are some jobs which are very painful and their labor delight in them sets off. Sets off means compensate or to make good, to compensate or to make good. That is the meaning of set off. So he says that there are some tasks which are very painful, right, which are very tedious, but the pleasure which they give you, that compensates for the pain and for the effort. That makes good all the efforts and the pain which you take to do these tedious jobs. Some kinds of baseness are nobly undergone. And then he says that there are some jobs which are very, very mean, which are very humble. Right? So they are base jobs, are nobly undertaken. But what happens? There are some jobs which give noble results also. Means though they seem to be very low jobs, not very good jobs, very menial kind of jobs, very humble kind of jobs, but the results which they give, they are very great. They are very noble. Are nobly undergone means the results which you get from these kind of jobs, they are glorious from menial jobs. There are certain jobs which are, it seemed to be of very low nature, it seemed to be of menial nature, but they give glorious results. They give very noble results. This, my mean task, would be as heavy to me as odious. So he says, this mean task which I am doing. See, Ferdinand was a prince, and carrying logs for a prince is obviously not something very respectable, right? It will be kind of humiliating, right? Not only the nature of the job, that it is tedious and it is not very comfortable to carry the log. More than that, it will be humiliating for him because of his position. So he says, and most poor matters point to the rich end. So, and most poor matters point to the rich end means, and most humble matters, they give rich ends, one means they give good results, they give great results. This my mean task would be as heavy to me as odious. So this mean task which I am doing, which, what is the mean task which Ferdinand is doing? The mean task of carrying the log. This mean task, this menial work which I am doing, would be as heavy to me as ordinary. So this menial job, this low job which I am doing, is both tedious to me. Heavy means tedious, means tiring. Is both tedious to me as well as odious. Odious means which is hateful, which is very disgusting, detestable job. Right? So this job is not only tiring but also hateful. But the mistress which I serve quickens watch time. So, but what happens? But still I am happily doing it. Why? Because the mistress to whom I am serving. Why this is not annoying me? Why this kind of job is not making me angry? Or why I am not irritated while doing this job? Though this job is physically tiring for me, and though it is a hateful kind of a job, I don't want to do it. But still, what is the reason that I am happily doing it? The mistress, which I serve, quickens what's there. So, the mistress for whom I am doing this job, that is Miranda. He's talking about Miranda. But the lady for whom I am doing this job quickens what's dead. Quickens what's dead means she is adding pleasure to this drudgery which I am doing. She is adding pleasure. She is adding happiness to the dull nature of my job. This thought which I have in my mind that by doing this job, by doing this menial kind of task, I am pleasing the lady whom I love so much. This thought is making me feel happy. Though the nature of this job is not good, though the nature of this job is hateful, though this job is disgusting, irritating, but still, the thought that I am serving the lady whom I love so much is making me do it happily and makes my labors pleasure. So this thought is turning my labor, my efforts into pleasure. Oh, she's 10 times more gentle than her father's crab. Crab means hard-hearted, having a very cruel and tough-hearted person. So that is, you know, what he's saying. So, oh, she's 10 times more gentle. So now now Ferdinand is comparing Miranda to Prospero. He says that she is 10 times more kind, she is 10 times more generous than her father, who is hard-hearted, right? Who is very cruel, who is very irritable. So, she is 10 times kinder than her hard-hearted father. And he is composed of harshness. And his father is composed of harshness, cruelty. Father is a cruel person, but she is far more generous, 10 times more gentle than her father. I must remove some thousands of these locks and pile them up upon a sore injunction. Upon a sore injunction means under the threat of punishment. Because Prospero, you remember, has threatened him to punish. What type of punishments did he say? He will give to Ferdinand that he will be made to eat shellfish, right, drink sea water, then eat husk. So he will be tortured by all these things. So he says that because of the fear of punishment, I should lift some thousand of these logs and make them into one single pile. So he has been asked to accumulate, to pile up, or to make a heap of all those logs. So he said that I need to do it. I need to lift some thousand logs and pile them at one place for the fear of being punished. Or else this person, this hard-hearted person, the father of Miranda, will definitely punish me. My sweet mistress weeps when she sees me work and says such baseness had never like executed. He says that my sweet mistress, who is the sweet mistress? Miranda. Because you remember Miranda, how she was pleading in front of her father, right? How she was pleading to her father, please don't punish him. I am ready to take his surety. She went to the extent of saying, it was just 5 minutes ago that she has seen Ferdinand and she was ready to be his surety that I am ready to take his guarantee that he is no spy. He is not a spy and he will not snatch away your island from you. So she was madly in love with him. So now he is recollecting those thoughts and he says that my sweet mistress, my gentle mistress weeps when she sees me work. When she sees me working so hard, when she sees me performing such difficult tasks, she weeps. She feels sad about me. She pities me. And says such business had never like executed. And what does she say? She says that she has never seen such a noble person like me perform such a menial job. Like, she has never seen such a great performer doing such menial jobs. Executor means performer. So such a noble performer doing such kind of menial jobs. I forget, but these sweet thoughts even refresh my youth. And then he says that, but I forgot that these sweet thoughts, these sweet memories of my lady, these sweet memories of the interaction which I had with my lady, they refresh my labors, they lighten my labor. When I think about all these things, when I think about Miranda and how she feels for me, then these thoughts, what do they do? What impact these thoughts have upon me? They lighten my labor. They refresh my labor means they lighten my labor. Means I don't feel any pain. I don't feel tired while lifting those logs. Most busy, less when I do it. So what happens? I feel that I am least busy when actually I am working the most. When I am putting in the maximum amount of labor, then also I feel that I am not busy at all. Why? Because I am mentally very happy at that time. When I think about Miranda, when I think about how she felt for me, so then I feel so happy that in spite of being really very busy, I don't feel it. In spite of getting tired by lifting those logs, I actually don't feel it. Right? I still feel refreshed and I still feel relaxed. See, your mind is very important. If you are mentally happy, no work will make you feel tired and no work will seem to be tedious. Right? So because he was, his mind was very happy. He was mentally very happy. His heart was very happy. Why? Because he was in love with Miranda and he kind of felt that Miranda also likes him. So this made him feel so happy that he didn't feel any pain in doing such difficult job. Enter Miranda and Prospero at a distance. So enter Miranda. So Miranda comes there. How will she sit peacefully when her beloved is working so hard, right, lifting the logs. So she couldn't stay away from him and she came there. And Prospero at a distance unseen. And who is there? Who else is present there? Prospero is also present there, but he is hiding away, right? He is not visible to Ferdinand or to Miranda, right? He is just there to witness their conversation. Means what are they talking about? So he is just there in hiding and not visible to any of these two people, these two persons. Miranda, alas, thou, pray you, work not so hard. So now Miranda couldn't just see Ferdinand working so hard and she says that it's really sad. I pray you, I request you, work not so hard. Please don't work so hard. I would the lightning had burnt up those logs that you enjoying to fight. So she says that I wish, I desire that may lightning fall upon those logs and burn those logs that you are enjoying. Enjoying means that you have been instructed, that you have been ordered to lift. May lightning fall upon them and may these logs burn to ashes. Right? Why? Because of the, it's because of these laws that you are working so hard. You have to undergo such a great amount of pain because of these laws. So it's better that lightning falls upon them and they are burnt to ashes. Pray, set it down and rest you. So he says, I request you, please set it down. Please keep those locks down and rest for some time. This is my humble request. I want you to rest for some time. I cannot see you working so hard. So please keep these locks for some time and rest. When this burns, it will weep for having wearied. So he says that when these locks will be put into fire, when these locks will be burned, because these locks are being piled up to make fire. Right? So he says that when these logs will be burnt in fire, what will happen? They also will weep. They also will feel sympathy. Even these logs will sympathize with you when they will be put into fire, because they have wearied you. They have made you so tired. They have made you so fatigued. They have made you so exhausted. So even these logs will have sympathy for you. My father is hard at study. So my father is hard at study means my father is engaged in serious study at the present moment. My father is very busy, seriously busy in his study. Pray you now, rest yourself. So I request you, I pray you that please keep these locks aside and rest for some time. He is safe for these 3 hours. I tell you, I know my father, because once he goes into the study room, then he doesn't come back before 3 hours. So he's safe means he is very safely away from us. He will not come out and trouble you for the next 3 hours. So in the meantime, what you can do, you can rest. Ferdinand, oh most dear mistress, the sun will set before I shall discharge what I must describe. So Ferdinand says that, my dearest mistress, I need to tell you that I need to finish. Discharge means carry out my duty before the sun sets. Because Prospero must have instructed Ferdinand to carry those logs and make them into a pile before sunset. So he says that I must strive to do, I must work hard, I must try to do my job, I must try to finish my work. I must try to finish the task which has been assigned to me before sunset. Miranda, if you will sit down, I'll bear your locks the while. Pray, give me that. So Miranda says that, please, okay, fine. If you want your job to be done, if you are not ready, if you have a target to accomplish, if you want to finish your job before sunset, then I have another offer. And what is it? That you rest for some time. And in the meantime, when you are resting, what will I do? I will carry the locks for you. I'll bear your locks means I will carry your locks. Meanwhile, means when you are resting, then I will carry your locks. Pray, give me that. So then she asks Ferdinand to give her the locks, that you please give that lock to me. I will carry it while you are resting. I'll carry to the pile. I'll carry to the pile means I will just carry the locks to the heap. Ferdinand.
Pratiksha, ma'am.
So Ferdinand says, now this was something very weird for Ferdinand, right? That Miranda, the lady whom he admires so much, he's going to carry the logs and he's going to rest. How will any man tolerate this? So he says that, no, precious creature, I had rather crack my sinews, break my bone, then you should such dishonor undergo while I sit lazy by. So he says that, no, this is not possible, precious creature. Precious creature means sweet lady, my dear lady. This is absolutely impossible. How can you even think of it? I had rather crack my sinews. Means it is better that I strain my sinews, means muscles. It's better that I strain my muscles. I have strain in my muscles. Break my bone. Even if my back is broken, then you should such dishonor and don't. Then you should go take such insulting, such humiliating task. How can I allow you to do such a humiliating task while I am just sitting there and resting, lazy by me while I just sit there and rest and be idle, and you are working so hard. It's better that I break my muscles, I strain my muscles and I break my bone, backbone. That would be a better option than to see you doing this job, doing such a menial, such a insulting kind of work. I cannot allow you. This is not possible. Miranda, it would become me as well as it does you. And I should do it with much more ease, for my goodwill is to it, and yours it is again. So Miranda says that it would become me. It would become me means it. Don't worry, right? Relax. It would be as proper for me if this job is appropriate for you. If this job is not insulting for you, if you are okay doing this job, then I will also be fine doing it. If this job is fine for you, this job is appropriate for you, then this job will also be appropriate and proper and fine for me as well as it does you. And I should do it with much more ease, for my goodwill is to it, and yours it is again. And then Miranda says, and it will be more easier for me to do this job than you. Why? It will be more easy for me to do this job. Why? Because my goodwill is to it. Goodwill is to it means because I am doing it willingly. Miranda is willingly making an offer to Ferdinand because she wants to help him. Right? So Miranda is taking up that job out of her own will. It is her wish to do that job. So any job, any work which you undertake to do out of your own wish, out of your own desire, that job doesn't feel tedious to you. You are okay doing it because it was your wish. So that is what Miranda says, that it will be easier for me. I will do it with more ease, with much more ease. So this job will be easier for me in comparison to you. Why? Because my goodwill is to it. I am doing it willingly, and yours it is against. And you are doing it unwillingly. This job has been forced upon you. You are doing this job reluctantly. You don't want to do it. You are doing it unwillingly, under the threat of punishment, because my father Prospero actually forced you to do this job. So that is the difference between you and me. So that is why it will be easier for me than it is for you. Prospero, aside, whoever thou art infected, this visitation shows it. So Prospero, I told you, was standing there, not visible to Ferdinand and Miranda, and he speaks to himself. He says, whoever means poor creature, now you are infected. Now you are infected means now you are affected with love. Now you are infected with love. This visitation shows it. Who is the poor creature now here? The poor creature here is Miranda. He's talking about Miranda. That poor creature, now you have fallen in love. I can see it. This visitation shows it. Visitation means this secret visit which you have paid to Ferdinand. Miranda came to meet Ferdinand without informing Prospero. And Prospero, according to Miranda, was busy in his study. This is what Miranda thinks. Prospero is there. She is unaware of this fact. She doesn't know that Prospero is there watching her secretly. What does she believe? She believes that her father is studying. And so she came secretly without informing her father about this visit paid to Ferdinand. So that is what Prospero says, that this secret visit which you have paid to Ferdinand, you have come here to meet Ferdinand secretly. And this secret visit makes it very obvious that you are infected with love. That now, my dear daughter, poor creature, you are infected with love. Miranda, you look very. So Miranda says that you look so tired, you look so exhausted. He says to Ferdinand, no, noble mistress, 'tis fresh morning with me when you are by at night. So Ferdinand says that, no, dear mistress, I'm not tired at all. When you are with me, when I am with you, when you are sitting in front of me, then what happens? Even the night will seem like a fresh morning. This means it is fresh morning with me when you are by at night. So even if it is night, if you are with me in a dark night, that night also seems to me like a fresh morning. I do beseech you chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name? So till now he didn't ask Miranda's name, right? So he says that I do beseech you. I do beseech you means I request you. I beg you. So I beg you chiefly. And what is the reason that I am making this request? Because so that I can just take your name when I am praying. So please tell me your name. I don't want to know your name, but just because I want to pray for you whenever I pray, I want to take your name also in my prayers. So that is why I want to know. What is your name? Right? So kindly tell me your name because I want to include you in my prayers. So what is your name? Miranda. So Miranda just says that my name is Miranda. Oh my father, I have broke your hest to say so. And then she realizes that she has broken the promise which she has made to her father. Hest means order, instructions. Hest means behest. Behest means to the command or order. So she says, when Ferdinand asks her name, she immediately utters her name. She says, Miranda. And then she realizes that, oh my God, what have I done? I have disobeyed my father by telling you my name. I have broken the hest. I have broken the command which was given to me by my father. Prospero must have instructed her not to reveal her name to Ferdinand. And she told her name when Ferdinand asked her. So that is what she says, that I have disobeyed my father's command and instruction. I think we should keep it till here and we'll continue with this tomorrow.